I'll be presenting on anatomical variations and artifacts in glaucoma. Artifacts are mainly classified into two types: red disease, which is a false positive diagnosis where the software mistakenly identifies an abnormal eye, although there is no glaucomatous damage, and green disease, which is a false negative, where the software where there is a glaucomatous damage is present, but the software is unable to identify it. Anatomical variations in RNFL bundle are a common cause of red disease. Normally, superior and inferior poles of ONH receive the largest number of RNFL as two thick bundles, which forms the basis for color-coded normative database of TSNIT profiles. The two anatomical variations that can be seen are split RNFL bundle and shifted RNFL peaks. The RNFL thickness is in the normal range, but it does not fit the expected configuration of TSNIT profiles on the OCT normative database. Hence, they cause false positive results. In a split RNFL bundle, the superior, inferior, or both bundles may be split and enter the optic nerve as two distinct bundles. It is more commonly observed as a local RNFL defect, but it should be distinguished from the real RNFL loss. In this report, Cirrus report, we can see that the superior bundles have a split, and this can be correlated with the two prominent humps in the RNFL thickness graph, which can be seen in the superior quadrant. Also, here in the quadrant map, although the superior quadrant is borderline, but the temporal and the nasal RNFL bundles are above 95% percentile, which shows us that this is a normal RNFL profile. And the patient also has a normal ganglion cell analysis. In the shifted RNFL peaks, peaks are shifted to temporal or nasal side. Due to difference in the topography of the bundle location, they can show abnormal report. The location of the RNFL peak correlates with the angle of the major retinal vessels. It is most commonly seen in higher myopes and distortion. In this report, we can see that the inferior bundles are shifted towards the temporal side. The RNFL map shows a double hemp pattern, but the peaks are shifted to the temporal areas. In this, in the quadrant map, the inferior RNFL in both eyes is outside normal limits, but the temporal RNFL profile has increased thickness. So in this also, the RNFL profile is normal. The PanoMap analysis of both the eyes shows normal GCC profile. Artifacts are very common in a OCT finding. Artifacts can be due to patient-dependent, operation-dependent, due to motion artifacts, segmentation artifacts, and it can be device-dependent. Low signal strength is any value of the signal strength below the device manufacturer recommended minimum threshold. When a signal strength degrades, RNFL, GCIPL, and GCC are measured thinner than they actually are. It's most commonly seen due to cataract, dry eye, corneal scar, dirty OCT lens, or vitreous floaters. Usually, the small pupil size may cause block signal due to the laser beam hitting the edge of the undilated pupil, so which can be seen as black areas in the thickness map, which can result in loss of data and which can be seen as a thin RNFL in a pie thickness chart. Hence, as a rule, we should always dilate the patients to decrease the variability and artifacts. Cataract diminishes scan quality index and decreases the RNFL thickness. Hence, it is best to do the OCT scan after cataract surgery. TFM abnormalities cause low signal strength. Already glaucoma patients have pre-existing ocular surface disorders due to drug toxicities. Hence, we should ask the patient to continue physiological blinking and just blink before the scan, and we can use the lubricant eye drops whenever necessary. Blink artifacts are caused when the patient blinks. During the scan acquisition, black horizontal bands, it can be seen as black horizontal bands on the thickness and NFAC image, vertical black bands on retinal and as a vertical black bands on the retinal tomograph. The loss of data correlates with the duration and number of blinks. The RNFL as well as area measurements will be abnormally low in these areas. Motion artifacts are caused when the eye being imaged or the head moves during data acquisition or reconstruction process. It appears on the in-face image as a break in the continuity of the retinal vessels, and or as a misalignment of the ONH and cup margins on the in-face and retinal tomograph. Improvement in the SD-OCT scanning speed and acquisition have reduced the likelihood of motion artifacts. In this scan, we can see in the right eye the disc is shifted towards one side, and on a deviation map, we can see that there is break in the continuity of these vessels. Hence, this is a motion artifact which has caused abnormal RNFL profile. On the rescan of the same patient on the same day, the RNFL profile has come to normal. Mirror artifacts are especially seen in foreign domain OCTs. There is a abnormal foreign domain detection due to the foreign domain is unable to identify the positive and negative time delays. As a result, a mirror OCT images are produced that are symmetrical around the zero time delays. It is commonly seen in myopia, retinal detachment, retinoschisis, and tumors. In this image, we can see that there is a mirror artifact. This is a high myopic patient, and due to extreme curvatures, the mirror artifact is seen, which is depicted by the white arrows. This is a scan of the patient having retinal edema, and the mirror artifact is caused due to sudden thickening and elevation of the retina, and this is the mirror artifact. In this, we can see that due to mirror, there is duplication of the fovea due to mirror artifact. Here we can see on the in-face image, there is an abrupt transition and discontinuation of the vessels noted by the red arrows. A normal scan should be well centered either on the ONH or fovea. Any scan taken away from these locations is called as decentered scan, which may be unintentional, malfunctional due to built-in automated scan centration system or poor fixation. This is a spectralics OCT scan showing decentration error. The scan circle is closer to the inferotemporal disc border. RNFL appears thinner and even dropping to zero at some locations. The correct placement of the scan circle on the optic disc in the same eye, the RNFL profile has changed. The segmentation error is caused due to incorrect delineation of the boundaries of the optic nerve head and the cup and anterior and posterior borders of RNFL, GCIPL, and GCC. It is more common in advanced glaucoma, peripapillary atrophy, and vitreoretinal diseases. The RNFL thickness can never be zero or close to zero due to presence of glial cells and retinal vasculature even in the advanced glaucomas. Hence, a global RNFL, GCC, or GCIPL thickness less than 50 microns is always due to segmentation errors, and a focal RNFL defect of less than 30 micron is always due to segmentation error. This is a RTVU scan showing the segmentation error due to misidentification of both the borders of the RNFL, which is causing abnormal RNFL graph and abnormal RNFL profile. This is a segmentation error due to peripapillary atrophy. The scan circle is passing through the peripapillary atrophy in the superionasal sector, which causes a failure to identify the lower border of the RNFL. And we can see in the superior quadrant, superionasal quadrant, the RNFL line is dropping to zero, which is physiologically impossible due to fluor effect. The larger areas of peripapillary atrophy, there is lack of contrast between RNFL and remaining eyeball layers. Hence, we can see the defects. 3.46 mm RNFL circle causes erroneous measurements in these areas, and the largest scan circle can be used in the presence of PPA, which is present in the spectralis OCT. Here we can see a segmentation error present in the case of vitromacular traction. The segmentation algorithm has taken posterior hyoid as the anterior edge of RNFL. This is a scan of a glaucoma patient, but due to abnormal segmentation, we can see that the RNFL profile in the nasal sector has normal due to segmentation error. This is a scan of V circle over the RNFL calculation circle. The RNFL, the V ring coincides with the RNFL circulation circle in the other variety is the oblong plane scan. Depth of 2 mm. Posterior wall of high myopic eyes has curvatures that exceeds these limits. Hence, normalized due to improper and it can also be seen in normalized due to improper scan acquisition. Hence, the key points of this presentation are: we should not interpret only the OCT report based.
Ma'am, the time is up, so if you could sum it up or stop your screen sharing. Can we move to the next speaker, please? Thank you.